That automatically changed my perspective of him. And first of all, like I said, proper perspective take time. I should have never really had a perspective because I didn't have enough information.
Especially not a negative one.
Yeah, yeah. Especially not a negative one because I didn't have enough information.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? Right. So, man, yeah, man, perspectives require good information, man. They require solid information.
Really do.
Y'all, man, y'all got anything else y'all want to say about that?
I'm just sitting over here thinking, like, what if you wish somebody had a different perspective on you? Like, for example, earlier in our podcast, we talked about being black in America. And I always had this thought, like, what if, like, other Europeans, I don't like using the word white. What if other Europeans? Well, I said,
that's,
all right.
That's worse than white.
What if Caucasians didn't pursue me as a threat? What if off the bat when you see me, you don't have fear, I guess? Like, what if you looked at me and then you just, like I said, like, for example, it's plenty of times, like, we'll go places we see, like, I can use this, for example, like, several times I go to Chipotle, I wait in the line. As soon as I walk up, it'd be several ladies, like, clutching their purse real quick, holding it to it. Like, they think I'm gonna snatch their purses right off. Like, what if you had that different? what if you have a different outlook on me? Like, it's crazy how I used to, like, when I was younger, I felt like a lot of people had ill will, which there is. Like, what if I'm getting my words, Mr. But, growing up, like I said, I thought, like, a lot of people had bad will on me. Till now, growing up, I realized, like, stop closing your door, stop closing, like you said, the bridge, and communicate more. See how another person think, you know, where they come from, and, like, you know, get other, you know, perspectives on them. Now, like, when I'm talking, like, for example, like, when I'm in the school now, in the high school, and when I'm talking to the kids, like, off the rip, they think, oh, I'm a substitute. I don't know what I'm talking about. And, man, like, forget what you talk about. Like, so now, like, when I'm talking to them, I always say, I say something and then I say, like, no, I'm just asking the question. I just wanted to get your perspective or how you think. And, you know, off the rip, then when they hear that, they're like, okay, yeah, he cool. He just, you know. And like I said, like, that's why I had the question, like, what if you want to change other people's perspective about you? So yeah, so that's like kind of a little
what twist. What if you want to change other people's perspective on you?
Like,
no, I'm not challenging the question. I was repeating it.
Yeah. Like, yeah. I'm trying to see if I can rephrase it. But yeah, this simple term, yeah.
Can you change somebody else's perspective?
That's what I was just saying. I don't really think it's your job to change somebody else's perspective about you. I think that's all up to them. I mean, of course, it does sort of kind of come down to your actions and the things you do and what you say. But ultimately, at the end of the day, it's left on them and how their perception is going to be on you. I don't think you can physically make somebody change their perception on you. I mean, even if you want to, like you just said, man, it's people that don't know us, they always gonna feel some type of way about us black men because of what they see on TV every day. Right. Yeah. Right. And I can go to a store, hold a door for a white person and be the nicest person ever. That's still not gonna change their perspective on me, you know, because of what they seen or maybe what they've been through with a person of our color.
Got pistol up by old black.
You know what I'm saying? Well, yeah, I just want to ask that question because I'm pretty sure there's a lot of people out there that think that way.
I think that the best thing may be, first and foremost, to not force your perceptions on other people and then to allow others to have their own perceptions.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Regardless of what they may be and how you perceive their perception. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
Whether you perceive it as a negative thing or, because like Travis said, you don't know where they get that perception from.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? If somebody don't have,
if you never had a conversation with them.
Right. They don't have a certain experience base. Now, granted, we did say that you probably, it's probably not best or beneficial to draw a perception off of a limited knowledge base. Mm-hmm. But if somebody is ignorant to that fact, then you have to allow them, you have to accept their level of consciousness. Mm-hmm. You know? And that is, Jarvis, that you bring it up, it is very, very, very difficult for me. Because one thing, I am a very judgmental person. And I am actively working on it, but I am extremely judgmental. You know what I'm saying? Like, I tear things down. And I listened to a video, man, and the dude gets into things about intelligent people, and intelligence is a knife, you know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. Like, intelligent people, like scientists or whatever, they know things by breaking it down.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Like, by cutting it. Yeah. You know what I mean? Not by accepting it and allowing it. So, like, if I want to know you, is it best to cut you?
Dissect.
Is it best to dissect you to know you? No, you know what I mean? Like, it's not best to cut a human up right into pieces to figure out who they are.
Mm.
And so sometimes my intelligence works against me because I attack everything from a level of intelligence, and everything does not have to be a level of intelligence. Some things are just existential. Some things are just existing,
right,
allowing things to happen and then seeing how that goes. You know what I mean?
Mm-hmm.
You had some nice flowers on the table when we got here, Trav.
Yeah.
Casanova.
Yeah.
Yeah, man. But should my best understanding of a flower be from cutting it into pieces?
Mm-hmm.
Or picking it up and smelling it?
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
You know what I mean? And feeling the texture of
shaking
it.
Shaking it out.
Yeah, yeah, and seeing how the wife reacts when I give them to her.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I mean? That's probably the best way to understand a flower. You know what I mean? You probably shouldn't cut it up into a thousand little pieces and be like, oh man, look at these buds, right? You know what I'm saying? The petal turns this way.
Yeah,
like,
yeah,
that's not so important to the existence of the flower. Right, you feel me? So, yeah, man, like I said, man, understanding your perspective, not forcing your perspective on other people, and then allowing other people to have their perspectives, no matter how limited. You know what I'm saying? Because they can only work from their level of consciousness.
Right.
They can't work from your level of consciousness. They can't work from your level of awareness. They can't work from your level of mindfulness. They, like, their expectation can't be for everybody to operate on your level.
Right.
So, at least if you want to live a less frustrating life.
Nah, yeah.
If you, if you, you want to spend your time, I mean, you can, man, but that's time consuming. Trust me, I know.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? And it's aggravating and it's frustrating. And I'm telling you, for people wired like myself, it's hard to let go. You know what I'm saying? To release a little control. It's hard, bro. You know what I mean?
Because
I got the reins tight. I got it tight. You know what I'm saying? I'm holding on tight. Yeah. You know what I mean?
Tight.
I'm holding on like that, man.
Veins popping up.
Yeah, man. Oh, that's just swollenness, you know. Come on, baby. Yeah, man. I think that's a good discussion, man. Probably a beneficial discussion as well, man. Because perspective, like we said, man, it's a powerful thing, man. It could really affect your quality of life.
Yes, indeed.
Or life, period. You know what I'm saying? Whether you even live in life or just, like Trav, you used the word earlier, just existing.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? There's a major difference, man. And it's crazy how all of it can be changed just from a switch of perspective.
Yeah.
Like, this earlier today, the quality of my life was changed by a different perspective that you offer.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? I viewed the situation this way. I felt stressed about it. Like, my heart, you know, I felt the tightness. I was uncomfortable with it. Boom. Trial come with another way to look at it. Like, did you give it your, you, like, you did everything you could, you know what I'm saying? Because I told you, I wore like a Hebrew slave this morning, you feel me?
Yeah.
Did I do everything I could? I'm like, yeah, I did do everything I could. Child, like, that's a win.
Yeah.
I'm like, oh, I won. I bet.
Yeah.
you know, I thought I lost.
Yeah.
You feel me? Okay, I got me all W. Appreciate that. You know what I'm saying? Like, the quality of my life was changed, boom, just like that.
Yeah.
And it's not, we're not talking about nothing that deep.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Yeah. I ain't had to go meditate. I ain't had to go read nothing. I just had to get some, Trey gave me some more information in. I applied that information and boom, I was on to the next. You know what I mean? So, yeah, man. Man, I love talking with y'all fellas, man.
Yes, indeed, man.
Yo, Jarvis, man, I really want you to be safe at that schoolhouse, man. Nah, I'm just playing.
I'm gonna be safe regardless, but like, yeah. I said, man, it's an overwhelming feeling, because like when I walk through the hallways, like I said, I talk to everybody, man. I dap hands, man. I embrace everybody, uplift people. I tell people, you know, you are queens, you are kings. Because that's what we use in, it's called the castle. So I just remind people, like, you know, you are kings, you are queens.
The castle.
That's what they're referring. No, that's their theme, I guess, whatever.
Okay.
Because, yeah. But yeah, man, it's, and like I said, like a couple of days ago, like Thursday and Friday, man, I walked through the hallways. I hear people say, you know, man, that's Mr. Ellis, man. That's my favorite substitute teacher. I was like, damn, I heard that one day. I was like, making a change, man. But yeah, man, like I said, I walk through a lot of people, man. I don't wish no negativity on nobody. Like I said, I have a good time. I walk around to each person, like I said, speak to them, ask them how they're doing. Are you having a good day? My name is Mr. Ellis. And I always know, remind them, because you know, young kids always curse. I like, queens don't curse, kings don't curse, you know. But yeah.
Yeah. Y'all remember that podcast?
Yeah. Hey, listen, I don't think you should tell them it don't curse. I think you should just say this ain't the place to do it.
Yes, that's what I say. Because like I always say, you know, this is the castle. So in the castle, kings and queens don't curse.
Okay.
Okay. And you tell them why?
Yeah. Because it's not the place, man. It's not time and the place, man. It's a learning environment. How you learn it from cursing, you know, using negative words and
Stuff like that. Yeah. I got you. Trial 4 o'clock. What's going on at 4, baby? Talk to me. Tell me something.
Roll right over them bulldogs.
Go dogs. Hey,
I ain't got no opinion on it, but I got an opinion on it.
Yeah.
But I tell you, man, SEC championship. I'm excited, man.
And
I'll be honest and say that I respect my competition today. Mm. I do have a healthy respect for Georgia and their football team.
Yeah, man.
I really do.
You win Georgia, man.
They have a solid football team, Charles.
Not me. I ain't getting no respect.
They have a solid football team, man.
Yeah, they got to show me.
Yeah, man. Defense.
Well, I don't want to get shown too much. So they ain't got to show me. I watched the first 12 games. You know, they ain't got to show me nothing.
Yeah, but, like I said, Baker got to show me something, because that's the matchup for the night.
You talking about that corner?
Corner, Baker. I know he
why is everybody focusing on that matchup when Bama has so many receivers?
I know, I'm just saying. He's
who, like, care if you take Judy out the game? What that mean?
I mean, I don't mean nothing.
Does he even have the most touchdown receptions for Alabama?
I don't know. I'm just saying, that's just one person in general. Everybody got to step up. You know, it's going to be a dog fight.
I feel like Tua throw that thing to everybody equally. You know what I'm saying?
This Georgia last chance right here. Yeah, I think they're gonna make them or break them. Either they're gonna be in or they're gonna be out, depending on this game.
Yeah, I mean, I think it's the same for us too, man.
Because I feel like if y'all win, we
gonna go to two.
Yes, I'm saying y'all still gonna get it.
Yeah, we still gonna get it.
I don't know about that, man.
All
right, I tell you, losses late in the season are detrimental. It's best to lose early like Georgia did. Hey, man, this is the What If Podcast, man. Yeah. Y'all got different perspectives.
That's right, man. That's right, man.
Hey, man.
I ain't about to try
to take y'all, change y'all boys' perspective, man. Yeah. Y'all want to be wrong, y'all wrong. Hey, Trav, what we got? Oh, man, we forgot to make your index card, man.
Oh, it's all good, man. What we doing? I'm telling them.
Everything.
What we leaving the people with?
Yeah. Dang. Ooh, I ain't even thinking that. It's saucy.
Don't worry about it. I got you, man. I go first. Give you some time to get your mind right.
Yeah, what you got?
Man, for me, I just tell people, man, just don't let everything and so much of things just get to you. You know what I'm saying? Just try to be as peaceful, as calm, as relaxed, as calm, man, as possible. I had two teachers came up to me yesterday while I was at work. He was like, man, Mr. Perry, you just always so calm, man. You never let nothing get to you. You know, even when you be dealing with the kids, they be had a little boy, man, jumping on the tables, going from table to table in the classroom, knocking everything off. So it's like, even in situations like that, man, you just so calm, man. Like, how you do it? Like, man, I just, I just don't let stuff get to me. You know what I'm saying? Like you say, like I've been practicing. I tell them and I meditate and I just I live in the moment, man. And you know what I'm saying? You gotta understand, especially working with kids, man. That's just what they do sometimes. You right. know what I'm saying? Of course, some of this stuff is unacceptable, but yeah, I mean, it's no point in me being mad about it or frustrated about it all day, 24/7, man. You just gotta know what to react to, like they say, man. You can't dance to every song. Some songs you just gotta sit out. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, yeah.
So, man, that's if I could leave everybody with that, man. Just don't try to dance to every song.
Don't try to dance to every song. That's good, that trap.
You don't dance no more. You don't dance no more. All they do. All right, my bad. But I guess I'm gonna go ahead and go. Pretty much, man, just realizing, man, what just took place, man. This is a great podcast, man, today, man. On perceptions, like you said, it is life. Like you said, I'm going to piggyback off that. Like Travis said, his perception on the kid, man, he just viewed things differently. So that's what I'm going to leave the people with, man. Just change, just look at things differently, man. And pretty much your goals, man, to try to reach to the highest point, man. I heard what the Pro Bowl cornerback Jalen Ramsey said one day. He said, don't tell me the sky's the limit when people been on the moon. And when I heard that, I was like, wow.
That's
so, nice. Yeah. Man. Yeah, man. Like I said, man, just don't let other people's perception on you define you, man. Just go hard, man, on everything you do, man. When you wake up, give 110% to everything, man, and just view life differently, man. Put your shoes in somebody else's shoes, man. And that's what I'm leading people with.
Y'all gave me time, man. I appreciate y'all, man. Time is one of the greatest commodities we have, man. I think my phrase of what I'm gonna lead people with today, man, is that is you. You know what I mean? Is you. Mm-hmm. Your life, your situations, what you may be dealing with, no matter how triumphant, no matter how what your perspective on it may be, regardless of anything, is you. You know what I'm saying? We did a podcast last week on the tools, you know what I'm saying?
Right, yeah.
You got to understand that your body, your mind, your emotions, your energy are tools. Mm-hmm. It's all they are. They are tools. Yeah. They're not you. They don't define you. They're not any of that. They tools, man. Mm-hmm. So whatever you allow your emotions to be, your energy to be, how you carrying and keeping your body and how you carrying and keeping your mind, it's all you, man. And if it's not in a desirable state right now, it's you. And if you desire for it to be better, or you change it for the better, it's still you.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? Don't export all your greatest qualities to heaven, man. Travis talking about peace and joy and that's you. Like, you can't say it's not you. Everybody, have you experienced joy before?
Mm-hmm.
Have you experienced joy before? Peace?
Yep.
Peace. Patience?
Yep.
Patience.
Yes, sir.
It's you.
Yeah.
You know, kindness. You experience that? Yeah. You experience like it's you have the ability to do it.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? You ain't sitting around waiting for nothing to make it happen. You don't need no life-shattering event. Like, it ain't that deep. You know what I'm saying? Like, it just really ain't that deep. It's you. And every moment and every situation is you.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? So take some responsibility. Understand that it's you, man. And I mean, you can make the change today. You know what I'm saying? You don't need no 12-step program. Like I said, man, it just ain't that deep. So I think we left the people with some great stuff, man. Trav, I wish we had your index cards, but we don't.
It's all good, man. Y'all want to reach us, man. Y'all can get us on Facebook at Pound. What if SAV?
Yes, it is.
Email whatifsavannah@gmail.com. What else we got?
Website.
whatifsav.com.
Okay.
Instagram, I think we whatif_SAV.
Okay.
You know.
What about YouTube channel?
YouTube channel is whatifsav, I believe as well, right? Pound what if.
Maybe you say that first.
Yeah.
Okay.
Pound what if is
so it's the same as the Facebook.
Yeah.
Okay.
Y'all can get us on YouTube, man. Anywhere, man. Reach out to us. Any comments, concerns, questions, anything, man. Reach out to us. We'll get back to you ASAP. Apparel coming soon. case they didn't know.
Yeah, man.
What if shirts?
That's the Christmas.
Oh, yeah.
Okay, so no more. Yeah, man. And as far as reaching out to us, another thing, man, that tutoring, man.
Tutoring, yep. That's,
you know what I'm saying? We where you want to be for the tutoring, man. You know what I'm saying? Math, English, Spanish, standardized test. Trying to get your kids right.
Yeah.
you need to hit us up, man. We more than about a grade, man. We want your children to know, I mean, who they are and their true potential. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
And like we said before, man, our number one goal for tutoring is to get you off as fast as possible. Yeah. For you to understand that you don't need us. You know what I mean?
Tools you need.
Yeah. Yeah, your tools you need or actually, you know what I'm saying, just to help you use the tools that you got. You know, we all got the tools, you know what I'm saying? You just gotta apply it. Sharp an iron. Hey. Good, eh? Hey, I'm good if y'all good, man.
Good. Yeah, man.
Hey, man, before we go, man, if everybody at the table can just join in on this, man. Can I get a roll tie?
Oh, I knew it was coming. I got you, man. Oh, roll tie. Roll tie.
Go dog, hey, baby.
We out, man.
Go dog.